Let him be subjected.
This unconventional decision by the LC5 chairperson of Nakasake District to subject teachers to mock exams stemmed from reported failures of primary level learners in the previous year's UNEB assessment. The LC5 chairman, Ignatius Kom, sought to assess whether these educators were culpable for the students' lackluster performance. An alarming 47 teachers were compelled to participate in these exams, raising eyebrows and prompting Minister Kaduchi to rebuke the LC5 chairman. She addressed the issue during the release of the Uganda Allied Health Examinations Board results at the office of the Prime Minister in Kampala.
Yes, Nakaseke subjected our teachers to exams, but that is not the best approach. They can do better using another approach. Another issue we can tell you, the district local government, by mandate, they're entitled to bring on board initiative that can improve the quality of education by the policy of decentralization. But if they bring in bylaws, the bylaws should first be approved by the Solicitor General. It has to go through the processes for approval to ensure that whatever initiative they bring on board does not demotivate the society.
In her candid statement, Minister Kaduchi condemned the actions taken in Nakaseke, labeling them as inappropriate. She urged local government authorities to explore more effective avenues for enhancing teacher training and capacity building, such as continuous professional development programs.
Nakaseke district leadership, led by the district LC5 chairperson, to subject the teachers to sit PLE examinations, that is uncalled for. Morally, it is not needed. It's going to demoralize our teachers, it's going to demotivate our teachers, and it is going to actually worsen the performance of the children. The best they can do is to ask for continuous professional education, to build the careers of the teachers, to improve the capacity of the teachers through continuous training.
Highlighting the broader implications of subjecting teachers to examinations, Minister Kaduchi underscored the erosion of professional respect inherent in such measures. She emphasized that this approach not only undermined the integrity of teaching as a profession, but also risked diminishing the esteemed teachers' command from both students and parents.
History will take a lot of interest. Already, the permanent secretary and the relevant authority, we need to reach out to help Nakaseke district to do better. Otherwise, that will demoralize the teachers, the morals will go down, and the teachers will not be able to perform to the expectations.
Meanwhile, over 1,360 students are set to retake exams with the Uganda Allied Health Examinations Board. 27,262 candidates registered for the November to December 2023 exams with the Uganda Allied Health Examinations Board. 20 candidates missed the exams due to various reasons, illustrating the diverse challenges students face. Of the final semester candidates, 6,016 passed, while 1,360 faced retakes, signifying both success and areas for improvement.
Final semester candidates were 7,376, and the continuing students were 19,856.
Now request our dear Honorable Minister for financial support to acquire more equipment and furniture for the effective utilization of the facility that has just been completed.
I want to request the tutors and the preceptors to put in more effort and ensure that students are guided right from the classroom.
The State Minister for Higher Education, John Chrysostom Muyingo, who represented the First Lady Janet Kataha Museveni, warned illegal institutions continuing to operate of consequences.
The ministry is working on the TVET bill and the National Education and Training for Health Policy is also being worked upon. This, when accomplished, will go a long way in streamlining training and assessment of health workers.
Exams tainted by malpractice were also cancelled. Report compiled by Sharon Navasidi for the news.